Welcome back. A memorial lecture paying tribute to anti-apartheid activists, the Kukuletu 7, has been held today. This as Human Rights Month draws to a close. The Kukuletu 7 were ambushed and shot dead by police in 1986. Our reporter, Nobesuthu Hetshana, is following the story for us and joins us from our Cape Town office. A very good afternoon to you, Nobesuthu. So what impact and legacy does the Kukuletu 7 have in the community?
Well, Morena, like you've correctly stated, they were shot dead in 1986 by apartheid police. Well, this month marks 35 years since they were shot, and the community of Kukuletu prides itself from what those young activists did back then, and they were calling them heroes. And even in that memorial lecture, they were hailed as heroes who fought for the country's liberation. So we spoke to the Deputy Minister of Agriculture and Land Reform, Mr. Mcebisi Skhwatsha, who also grew up in that community. He was telling us that at that point, when one of the seven young activists was shot dead, he did carry them asking for assistance, but he did say that their legacy will forever live on in that community. But let's take a listen to what he had to say.
The Kukuletu 7 were brave, gallant fighters who spilled their blood for us to be free today. Their legacy is for us to make sure that we build a united, non-racial, non-sexist South Africa. The ANC government in the Western Cape then did build those new monuments, the statues you see there. But that is not enough.
Now, families claim they were not part of the planning of the lecture and say they weren't invited to attend.
Well, Morena, just before that event start, we did see a bit of a commotion from the family and those who were leading that procession. And they were saying that they were sent by their families and that they were not happy that this event is held without them being consulted. But they were saying that they want government to refurbish that area and declare it a heritage site, because if you walk close to those statues, you see that most of them have been vandalized and some of the pictures are missing there, and the lights that were installed there, they're no longer there. So the families say they were saddened by the fact that they were not consulted, but they want more to be done to safeguard that space. But let's take a listen to a family member speaking.
Kangabasixelele ne thina ukuthi kuzokwenzeka lento apha ne asimindi ukuthi bangayisebenzisa thina le ndawo ne but baqale as family ukubona singabonisi kwi posters ukuthi kuzakwenzeka lento pha.
All right, that is our reporter Nobesuthu Hetshana coming to us from our Cape Town studio.